famous.
I don't know if.
Tell me, you want to be on TV?
You don't have to read.
You don't have to. You're gonna ask me questions, but.
What? I don't know.
Information. No.
Okay.
Yeah. Broccoli. What are you supposed to say?
Let it hydrate in your mouth for a little bit. You just gonna ask questions.
Who's a wildlife?
I guess people are very interested in it because it was on the news. Yeah.
It was.
All my friends that saw it on Instagram, they're like, "Oh my god, they actually exist." I'm like,
"So, yeah. But how did it get on the news when you picked it up? What did the guy say? He just when you picked it up?
We know.
Giving you information. I'm like, okay, cool. Let me know what you do with it because then I'm just gonna give him this one.
Yeah.
And I thought there were two. And then they're like, oh no, this guy named Nick picked it up. And I talked to him. I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
There's only one, and they don't last long in captivity by themselves.
I can't remember how the story goes. Where they came from the zoo originally.
Sure.
Yes.
So I read it. It was from a private zoo.
That's what I thought. Yeah.
Private zoo.
1960.
In Kalihi.
Jump on the cage.
Yeah.
No, it's more of like people are like, oh, so what are you guys gonna do with it? And it's like, nothing. Like that's why it's just like, not awkward, but
just keep it as a pet.
Well,
my grandma saw it on the news and she asked me. She was like, oh, so like, is it's okay? Like, cause I told her we're gonna release it, and she was like, oh, so it's not like invasive or anything. And I was like, no, like it's been here so long, like over 60 years, and still there's no population.
But actually, if you want Nick, if you want to.
I'm surprised nobody wants to do it.
Hair girl.
I don't know. We haven't even checked to see if there was anything in his pouch.
Yeah.
She said she has a deal on her
ID. You might ask us for that.
She called me because of the white turns down, and then she like randomly was like, oh, what about the long
by the way,
so,
I
and
I
was like, oh, okay. And then like later, I was like, oh, but then I felt bad.
Every time we just use our license, just keep that in your truck.
Definitely likes the mangoes. The mangoes are always
good.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I gave him sweet potato.
This wallaby was found in a home in Nu'uanu. It was subsequently taken to the Hawaiian Humane Society. At that point, the Humane Society contacted the Division of Forestry and Wildlife and said, hey, we have this wallaby. We'd like to know what to do with it. So we went over, we took a look at the wallaby, picked it up, had somebody from the Honolulu Zoo come in and inspect it to make sure that it was healthy and okay. After we got that okay, we're planning to release it in an area that we know there are other wallabies. Once we gain access to the site, we'll go and try to locate it as far away from any structures or houses as possible so that it doesn't come into contact with any other humans. In terms of management, they're protected by DLNR rule. So they're a species that fall under our jurisdiction. As far as management, they're not a native species. They're not an invasive species or a threat. So our stance in general is neutral. We know they exist by law. They're protected by us, but we really don't have any current or future management operations dealing with wallabies. As far as we know, only on Oahu, they escaped in the early 1900s from a private zoo. They've been around ever since. So the fact that the sightings and any kind of contact is scarce, we feel it's a good sign. The population's not growing, which means it's not going to become an issue because it's a non-native species. So they're just out there. We think that it's a relatively stable population. There's been a bunch of studies done in the 70s and 80s, and they sort of confirmed all of those things, and which is basically what we are basing all our information off of. Yep, it's all over the social media posts. It's a sort of a unique thing, which goes back to saying that, hey, these things are here, they've been here for a long time, but it's not really a problem in terms of natural resource management because you don't see a whole lot of it. You know, a lot of people's reactions are, oh, I didn't know those things existed, or I didn't know they were real. So because there hasn't been a whole lot of sightings, and because people's reactions have kind of been in the realm of, I didn't know those things really existed, or I've never seen one before. It's sort of a good sign for us as far as a resource management perspective. So we get this guy back out there, you know, get him back with the rest of the wallabies, and they can sort of exist in their own realm. You know, they're protected by the department. You know, we want them to be left alone, basically where they are, because it's not an issue for us from a resource management perspective. So, you know, we like to think that they are allowed to live in peace wherever they are, and as long as it's not an issue, we'll continue to treat them that way. Based on some studies that were done before, they eat a lot of fruits. I read Christmas berry, any kind of things that they can find, and obviously whatever is in the common structure of our forests and of our forested areas is, you know, they're able to find whatever they need. They live in groups, which the study sort of confirmed based on some of the population surveys. But we don't know for sure. It's been such a long time, and you know, they've been around for 100 years, so they've probably evolved. I don't know what they do in their natural habitat in Australia, but you know, I mean, that'd be something that we could look into in the future, and it may turn into an interesting project mm-hmm. for us.